RPG Maker Unite First Steps! Anya and Lolo here! Have you ever noticed that RPG Maker Unite characters appear more 3D even though they're on 2D sprite sheets? Well, that's because these are pre-rendered 3D graphics or 3D models that are rendered into sprite sheets. This technology isn't new. In fact, it was widely popular in the mid-90s. Back then, video game consoles couldn't handle real-time 3D graphics like they can today, so game developers had to get creative with some clever tricks. They filmed actors. For games like Mortal Kombat, they actually filmed real actors in costumes and turned those recordings into game sprites. For non-human characters, they used stop-motion puppets made of clay and other materials, posed them frame by frame, and then captured those shots to create animations in-game. That's how they did it in Primal Rage. But the technology closest to what we've seen in Unite was called silicon graphics for pre-rendered 3D sprites. It was used in games like Donkey Kong Country, Killer Instinct, and later Super Mario RPG. Developers used cutting-edge computers at the time called silicon graphics workstations, which were revolutionary in the 90s. These high-end machines enabled them to create highly detailed 3D models and animations for game characters and environments. They converted these models for systems like Super Nintendo Entertainment System or arcade machines. At that time, the hardware couldn't handle real-time 3D graphics at a playable frame rate. So, to make this happen, these 3D models were converted into 2D sprites, frame by frame, exactly the technology we see here in Unite. It allowed developers to emulate a 3D experience on 2D consoles. It had a very distinctive three-dimensional look with smooth animations and groundbreaking visual style that remains iconic. This method not only pushed the boundaries of game design back then, but also set the stage for the transition to full 3D gaming in later years. I really love this style. Sadly, not many games were able to afford the incredibly expensive silicon graphics workstations, and it was heartbreaking to see this style of graphics eventually fade away. That's why I feel so excited to see this technology making a comeback in RPG Maker Unite. I hope you enjoyed this little dive into game graphics, and this helps you better understand how character assets work in Unite. In the next video, we'll talk more about VRM models and how to add them in the software. See you next time!